With one of the latest Home Assistant updates, there is now changed and improved YAML syntax for the Home Assistant automations, and we are going to dive into that part in details. Some key changes have been made in the YAML code of the automations to make them easier to understand and more natural to use. But is it really the case, or they are more complicated now? Let's break it down. Now, here is the good news. These changes are not breaking changes. They are not breaking anything. The old YAML syntax will still work, so you don't have to rush to update all your existing automations. Home Assistant Crew has no plans to remove the old syntax. So if you're happy with your setup, no worries, just do nothing. However, the new YAML syntax is recommended, and any new automations you create in the Automation Graphical Editor will automatically use the updated style. Before we begin, I want to share that I made a PDF that goes with this video, and you can download it for free. I go into much more details there, and I've created some interactive activities so you can practice what you've learned and memorize it. To download the PDF, simply click the link in the description box. Follow this link or scan that QR code. Then you enter your name and your email address. You sign up for my mailing list and the PDF will automatically download to your device. After that, you've joined my free PDF club. You automatically receive my weekly articles, news, updates and offers. It's a free service and you can unsubscribe at any time with just one click. Now let's go straight into today's topic, the improved YAML syntax in Home Assistant automations. Here is a brief history. In Home Assistant 2024.8 release, the service key was renamed to action in both the UI and YAML. The goal of this was to make the syntax easier to read and understand. Following the same idea, they've now made some updates to YAML syntax in automations. Let's take a look at what's changed. The trigger key in automation is now plural. It's triggers. The condition key is now conditions. And the action key, you guessed it, it's now actions. Basically, everything is plural now to make it more intuitive. Since most automations have multiple steps, using the plural form makes it a lot more sense. Another change is within the trigger definitions. The platform key is now simply called trigger. So, what does this mean for you? In the new syntax, you'll be able to set up triggers with multiple trigger definitions, conditions with multiple condition definitions, and actions with multiple action definitions. Just like before, no changes in the functionality, but this update makes your YAML cleaner and easier to follow, at least for me. Let's take a quick look in one real example that I've prepared for you so we can understand that better. On the left side, you can see the old syntax of the automations, and on the right, you can see the new and improved one. This simple automation is turning a bedroom light at sunset. This is the trigger when the sun is sunsetting, and when the bedroom light is off as a condition, the action will turn it on. Same here, but let's see where are the differences. The first one, trigger here, like that, and here we have the triggers now in plural form. As you can see, trigger becomes triggers. And if I had multiple triggers, I'll have this thing multiplied below. Trigger, 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 and so on and so forth. The second change here is platform. Keyword becomes trigger here. As you can see, now we have trigger. Before the update, I had platform sum. Now it is trigger sum, like that. The trigger part below stays the same, event is sunset and offset and stuff like that. These are the changes in the trigger part. Trigger becomes triggers and platform becomes trigger. If I need multiple triggers, I'll have multiple trigger section here in the YAML as well. The condition part is the next change. The only change here is this plural form. Now we have conditions, and here in the old syntax we have condition, single form, like that. Condition become conditions, and below that nothing is changing. And we are going to the action. I'll copy and paste this line, and this is the action, and I'll paste it one more time, and I'll highlight it here. And action become actions. If I have multiple actions, multiple conditions, or multiple triggers, they all will be listed below here in these sections, in the respective sections, with single form. So one plural form section, and then multiple keywords in single form. Let me demonstrate you that in the graphical automation editors, then I'll show you the YAML. I'll add one more trigger. The trigger actually doesn't matter. For example, calendar. And I'll add one more condition. Again, the condition doesn't matter. I just want to have several conditions and several triggers, also several actions, like that. So now I have two triggers, two conditions, and two actions. Let's see the YAML, editing YAML. And as you can see right now, here I'll zoom a bit up, the triggers condition with plural form, and I have multiple trigger sections. That is the new and updated syntax for triggers. We have the same thing with conditions, conditions with plural form, and then multiple conditions below with single form without S. So one plural and multiple condition sections. Then we have actions, and here is the same. Action 1 and action 2. They are all in single form, not in plural like the main section. Nice and clear as white paper. If you're using the graphical automation editor, the generated YAML will be using this updated syntax, and that is my general recommendation. Just use the graphical editor to make your automations whenever that's possible. I hope this helped clear the things up. Let me know in the comments below, do you like this new and improved YAML syntax for Home Assistant automations? Typing simple yes or no is absolutely fine, because I'll know for what are you talking about. Thank you for staying on the YAML edge with me. I'm Kirill, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!